Today on Louisiana Outdoor Adventures TV, we're in Empire, Louisiana with Captain Shane Mayfield, and oh, what a day. We're throwing topwater, top dog juniors from Marilure, and also she dogs, and we have speckled trout, and we have redfish. It's an unbelievably gorgeous day, and boy, do we get lucky with an outstanding bite. It's all coming your way right here on Louisiana Outdoor Adventures TV. LOATV is brought to you by Lieutenant Governor Billy Nungesser and LouisianaTravel.com. Come to Louisiana where you catch fish.
That's a good trout. Hey, a little topwater action here, huh? How about that, Captain Shane?
Got you a little trout?
Got me a little trout. We're on the beach looking for some bull reds and some trout. That's a nice trout. Look at that.
There you go.
That's pretty. That's dinner. What's he got in his mouth? Oh no, it's my bait. Well, we got right up on this beach and we saw a lot of action and...
Nice little trout.
Give me the movement.
Oh, I got another one, man. Nice trout too. Nice one. I think I kind of found something here, Shane. Well, he's not as nice as I thought he was. He's foul hooked, but hell, he is nice.
What's wrong with that?
Whoops. A little catch and release. Just throwing right off this beach here. We saw some shrimp a little while ago, and I'm just going to keep throwing right there. And it's been a fish every cast. When you can go out here and throw topwater and get some hits, I mean, that's the ultimate fun, isn't it?
It really is. I mean, you know, and you don't, they, and people think, oh, you got to have it in the morning. And yeah, definitely, I think it's better in the morning, but it's not to say you won't catch them. Hey, yeah, little trout. But Kevin's caught a couple nice ones, had a big bull blow up on it. We'll just keep on seeing what we can do. Not a little trout. But it's a topwater strike, so it doesn't really matter, you know? You gotta be really careful. You know, they get crazy, they start jumping around. You wanna take your time when you're getting them off, because you know, they're called treble hooks, but I call them trouble hooks. You really gotta be careful. Because if not,
another 13-inch fish.
You end up with a hook in your hand. Get a good grip on him before you, just don't go grabbing at him. Ooh.
That's a bull, huh?
I don't know what he is. I hadn't really got a look at him. Hey, he might be a little better. It's just, sometimes it's hard to tell because they'll foul hook themselves with this top water. And when they do, you know, they'll pull a lot harder than they really are. Yeah, see, like, a lot bigger than they really are. But, I mean he's a respectable fish.
Yeah.
Probably 14 inches.
Like everything you said, anything you catch on topwater. I'm gonna throw out front here a little bit just to see.
But that tide's coming in.
Just to see if there's anything way out there.
Oh.
You got that one, huh?
Yeah.
He looks like he's a decent one.
About the same as those last couple. Oh, bleeding everywhere.
But you know, we're in really a bull red type of fishing month. We're in September right now, Shane, which is our transition month. So really, speckled trout are kind of a bonus if you catch them this time of year. They're moving.
So they're not, you know, they're in between the places they are in the summer, spring and summer, and where they're gonna be in the fall, early winter. So they're moving right now. But I mean, these outside points, I mean, this is an avenue where they travel through to come inside. So you get out here on the right day and you can catch them.
LOA TV is brought to you by Soft Science Supreme Comfort Footwear, the most comfortable footwear you will ever wear.
There he is.
Boy, you're fishing with a Top Dog Junior. I'm fishing with a She Dog, and all of a sudden your color got a little bit better than me.
There he is.
Yep. Looks like they're cookie cutters now.
Yep. The first couple you had were nice. These all, I mean, for eating.
Oh, that's all you
if,
want.
You know, which, I mean, hey, it's not all about the meat, at least not in my opinion, but if you want to bring some home, could look fresh, they're wonderful. If you want to bring some home, that's a 13, 14 inch trout, perfect size, in my opinion. All right,
there we
Kev,
go.
What you got, Kev?
I just got one behind you. I just said follow Captain Shane and look at him. 13 inches, yeah. Almost looks like a white trout.
Yep.
Well, we got him hooked good, didn't we?
Yep, he's in there good. Stop. Stop.
And you wonder sometimes how a fish misses a topwater bait. Six hooks.
Yeah, I mean, they just hitting at it so quick, yeah. I think they just ripped their face up a little bit, you know?
Ooh, golly. That was pretty awesome, huh?
Right at the boat. Woo! Heads up. And on that short line, boy, he didn't get the hook good. And plus, I wasn't watching. I wasn't paying attention.
I watched him hit it. Another trout. Sometimes when that sun comes up, though, it'll knock that topwater.
It does. Well, I mean, you know, it sounds crazy, but especially for the trout. I always say fish, if you know, fish don't have eyelids, right?
Right.
So, I mean, obviously, you know, when they're in the shallow water, the sun penetrates the water column better, you know, a lot brighter, and they're looking up to feed most of the time. So, I mean, I think right. When the sun comes out, a little harder for them to find a lure over the top, you know, and when it's cloudy, there's more of a contrast, so they can really see that topwater on the surface.
So let's go ahead and switch gears here for a minute, like you are. What do you think, Shane, the quirk or the jig?
Well, I mean, I'm still getting bites on the jig, but you never know, right?
Might get a bull. I'm thinking maybe I can scare up a bull red with quirk, you know?
I mean, these little trout are hitting me just about every cast. A lot of little ones, but it's bites. We're fishing, we're catching, and
now,
it's fun.
I didn't put my quirk line on here, so I'll get my quirk line out in a minute. What you doing, just casting and retrieving?
Casting and retrieving. I've kind of been changing it up. Some I'll bump some, and then maybe I'll go to just a slow retrieve.
Yeah. It's amazing, the fish are still there, but.
Yep.
That's a keeper.
Whoop. Oh, man. See that? He heard Kevin say that's a keeper, and he said, I'm getting off.
Yeah.
I'm going back.
Hey, that's okay. Oh, there we go.
You got one? There you go. Pull and go. Oh, there's one.
Yeah. Every cast here, huh?
Mine's feeling funny.
Mine's not. Oh, look at mine. I got a good one here. Let's see. Look at that, huh?
There we go.
Whoops.
Look at that, boy.
Look at that, huh?
What's wrong with that?
You know what's funny, Shane, we can tell people? Yesterday, we went out early in the morning, right?
Yeah.
And what did we go to do?
Look for big trout on top.
But look for speckled trout, right?
Yeah, on top.
All right. So today we said we're going to go look for redfish, right?
Yep, yep.
Speckled trout.
Well, you don't
Here,
know.
Put
it's
him in
fishing.
The back.
That's it's
a
fishing.
Pretty one.
It's fishing.
But you know what? It's a beautiful morning out here and we are having fun. And you never know what you are going to catch, especially down here in Plaquemines Parish.
LOA TV is brought to you by Ralph Sellers, Chrysler, Dodge, Jeep, and Ram in Gonzales, Louisiana's number one Ram dealer.
What's holding the, I mean, it's we're on a point right here. So.
Well, I mean, it's just, you know, just like, there's one.
That's a good one.
There's a lot of bait. Tide's still rising. A lot of bait. It's an ambush point, you know. nice tapering off point on the edge of the Gulf. And these trout are just in, I mean, typical, you know, if you look in a textbook, this is a typical trout kind of spot. It's a good ambush spot, moving water, not a ton, not, you don't want a big, big, big tide. Right. Nice little rising tide. We got some bait in here. Those fish are ambushing that bait up against the sandbar, and that's that.
And you know, when you, a lot of people talk about, okay, it's transition time.
Mm-hmm.
And I talk about this a lot, Shane. If you kind of put yourself, if you were a fish, what highway would you take from the outside to the inside?
Exactly.
And that's kind of how you have to think about catching fish this time of year. If you were a fish, which way would you swim?
Exactly, exactly. Yeah. This is a avenue by which they will get into where they're going to be in the fall and winter.
I think there's another one out there, though, Shane. If you cast right there, I think you're going to catch one.
Oh, see? Oh, look at that.
Don't you like it when I tell you where to cast?
That doesn't happen often.
I said, don't you? I said, you catch it.
I do like it. Thank you.
Come on.
There you go.
Yeah, I mean, these are, for this time of year, these are nice fish.
Well, they got some big ones around. Let him go back in and grow up a little bit. Every now and then, big bulls come up, boom, boom. And they'll eat these little trout, too, you know? I mean, the bull reds will definitely eat these trout. You know, some of these smaller ones we're catching, they'll definitely, the ones that were, you know, undersized that are hitting our lures,
mm-hmm.
they'll definitely, bull red will definitely eat that.
You about to get...
What? Boom! Now look, I know everybody likes to eat specks, but to me, if you like fishing, that's the deal right there. Big old, I mean, a bull red, you know, like probably 15, a little over 15 to 20 pounds. Oh, he pulled the hooks. Look, oh, I think another one just ate it, sure enough. And, you know, hit that thing on top water like that. How can you not like that? We got Kevin trying to still catch a trout on the front. I just couldn't resist. They were too close.
Well, Kevin's trying to catch a trout on the front. Kevin's got a trout on the front. Shane's got a, look at that. Kevin's got a nice trout on the front.
He is not happy.
Oh. I'm gonna get up here and help you, Captain Shane. Speckled trout on one side of the boat, bull reds on the other side of the boat.
They had a pile up because he came off, because I felt it. I mean, he came off because it was no, I reeled fast and it was nothing. I felt the bait drag and then all of a sudden, bam, bam. There you go, hold up, there you go.
Well, there's another one right there.
Hold that hook, I mean, hold that net up toward me. You just gotta be careful, you gotta be careful.
All right, we got that part done. I just saw another bull red come up.
That one's probably 13 pounds, maybe 14. All right, I'm gonna put this back in and we'll get back to action.
All right. So Shane, I have a dilemma, I have a problem.
What's that?
I can cast that way and catch one of those, or I can catch that way and catch a trout.
That's a good problem to have.
I'm casting this way.
LOA TV is brought to you by Lieutenant Governor Billy Nungesser and LouisianaTravel.com. Come to Louisiana where you catch fish.
The bulls are busting, so I'm just seeing if I can get them closer. What this is a big wooden, it's basically an offshore bait. It's actually for GT, giant trevally, which we don't have here, but think of Jack Crevel, much bigger. And I mean, you can see it was brand new when I got it, but I use it to tease the redfish closer in, especially if I'm doing fly fishing or whatnot. So we're gonna just throw it out there and see if I can get them to come up to it. Sometimes they will. They're really doing it most of the time they will, but sometimes they won't.
Seeing any fish hit a topwater bait from ground level is incredible and exciting. But when you get a drone out and start flying a drone over a topwater bait and you actually see the number of fish, not that hit it, but look at the number of fish that come up to it. It's unbelievable how many fish you don't see because you don't have this overhead view. It's amazing the amount of fish that are out there, and these redfish are just going crazy around this bait. They'll finally hit it, but you never know how many fish that really are out there until you get an overhead shot. If you ever have a chance to come out here and do this, please do. It'll be the trip of a lifetime. Trout?
Yep.
Nice trout.
Well, he just hit it. He just hit it like he was way bigger than he is. He's a nice one, but he nailed it.
He's dinner. Oh, that's a nice one there, buddy.
There he is. Nice chunky trout.
How the Pros Do It is brought to you by the Louisiana Charter Boat Association. Book your adventure today.
All right, check my jig, make sure it's swimming properly. You know, you want to check them. Every now and then, I'll see people just casting, not looking at the cockahoe. And if it's a little crooked, you know, it doesn't have to be on any particular way, but if it's, you know, up or down, but if it's crooked, it'll swim funny and twist your line up.
All right, come on. You hole jump. Oh, look at you hole jumping me. They're over there. See?
Even the little guys moved. Oh, I just had a little tap.
So now, let's talk about this for a second. We caught them early at the beach, like casting towards the beach. Mm-hmm. Now you said sometimes when the sun comes up, not only will they stop on top water, but the fish will move out a little bit, correct?
Well, I mean, yeah, as the sun gets higher, they tend to move in a little bit deeper water, you know? I mean, unless it's cloudy.
Right.
It's cloudy, you know, you got, even if the sun's up, I mean, we're not talking about the sun, so much the sun where it's at in the sky as far as, you know, if there's no clouds to block it.
Right.
Because I've been out here fishing, you're catching boom, 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 boom. Clouds move, body stop. Clouds move back in, boom, 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 boom. You know, they'll feed shallow when the clouds, you know, are in front of the sun. And sometimes when it gets up, clears up, they go deeper.
But it's fun to be able to sit here and, no matter what size they are, catch them every cast.
Well, yeah, I mean, you know, they're biting. So, I mean, you catch them and every now and then you get a nicer one and we're
just
fishing to have fun. It's about fun, right?
Right.
Look at that mule, boy.
Yeah. Whoops, that hurt. That fish has got a bad headache. Sorry about that, buddy.
See, if that was a brook trout, you'd be on the cover of the Virginian Times or something like that.
The Virginian Times Union?
Yeah.
Oh, you got one, Rick?
Yeah, I got another little schoolie. Another little schoolie. Let him go real quick.
Now, a lot of people would be like, why are y'all staying here catching these fish? And you know why?
Why?
Because we're having fun.
Exactly. I mean, we got the bull reds around. I mean, we're going to drift off here in a minute and try to catch those. There went one right there or something.
Yeah, big old bull red.
Something bigger. Something behind it.
Oh. There he is.
He swirled up behind it before he really nailed it.
So, let's see. Speckled trout on top water. Trying to figure all this out in like an hour and a half. Speckled trout on top water. Speckled trout under a popping cork, speckled trout on a jig, bull red on a popping cork, bull red on a jig, and bull reds on top water. Shane, what else could have we done?
I mean, fishing's supposed to be fun. I don't know how you can have any more fun than that.
I mean, a ton of fun. Oh yeah, and then we caught a bunch of schools and we caught a ton of little bitty fish and threw them back. I mean, how much more fun can you have? Let me get the net. Whew. Folks,
being happy.
This is one of those days. You don't get them all the time, but sometimes you get them and you enjoy them. And it's been outstanding out here, out of Empire, Louisiana, fishing out of Joshua's Marina today.
Going down deep
with Captain Shane Mayfield. You know, Shane, I don't know if we're going to have time to get this fish in before we have to tell everybody goodbye, but I'm going to go ahead and say everything we've got to say. I'm going to say there's your fish right there. I want to thank you. And if folks want to book a trip, all they have to do is call Adventure South Guide Service. Go to LouisianaTravel.com. Check out the Charter Boat Association website, Plaquemines Parish, Catching Capital. You can find everything you need about catching fish down here in South Louisiana. And that's what it's all about right there. For producer Joey Bordelon and Captain Shane Mayfield, I'm Kevin Ford, the guy with the net. Come down here and get you some. We'll see you next time on Louisiana Outdoor Adventures TV.